Welcome to the second lesson in the Google Tag Manager series. In this video, I'll show you how to add additional tags to your GTM container. We'll walk through the steps to add a Google Ads remarketing tag, the LinkedIn Insight tag, and a custom HTML tag for the Metapixel. We're going to start by adding the Google Ads remarketing tag to our website. Before we do, I want to quickly mention that in the first lesson in this series, we covered how to get started with Google Tag Manager. So if you've missed it, I've included a link for you in the description below this video. Okay, let's start by heading to our Google Ads account. We're looking at the new version of Google Ads. So to set up our Google Ads remarketing tag, we select Tools, then Shared Library, and we select Audience Manager. If you're using the previous version of Google Ads, you'll find this by selecting Tools at the top of the interface and selecting Audience Manager. We can see in my demo account there are three audience lists. These lists have been created automatically, so they're the default lists. And we can see there is a list called All Visitors. This is the list we'll send data to using Google Tag Manager. To do this, we need to add the Google Ads tag to our website. So let's select the Your Data Sources tab at the top. We can see the Google Ads tag, so let's click Details for this source. Now let's select Tag Setup at the bottom. Now let's select the option to add the tag using Google Tag Manager. And we need to copy the conversion ID. Now we can head to Google Tag Manager. Let's navigate to Tags. We can see the Google tag we created in the first lesson of this Google Tag Manager series. So now let's create another tag. Let's name the tag Google Ads Remarketing. Now let's select Tag Configuration. Let's select Google Ads and choose Google Ads Remarketing as the tag type. We can see an alert at the top saying conversion linker tag missing in the container. The conversion linker tag improves the accuracy of conversion tracking by storing information about the ad click using a first-party cookie on our website. If you already have the conversion linker tag in your Google Tag Manager container, then you'll see a message saying you already have the conversion linker tag. But since we don't have the tag yet, let's click Create. Let's name the tag Google Ads Conversion Linker. We're going to leave the default settings, but we can see the trigger has been automatically set to All Pages. This is okay, but it's recommended that we use the initialization All Pages trigger instead. So let's select Triggering. Remove the All Pages trigger. And let's select the initialization All Pages trigger. This will fire our tag on all of the pages of our website before any other tags, apart from any tags used for consent. Now let's save the tag. We're back on our Google Ads remarketing tag, so now we need to paste our conversion ID into the tag configuration. Let's leave the other default settings. Now we need to add a trigger to our tag, so let's select Triggering. Let's select the initialization All Pages trigger. This will add the Google Ads remarketing tag to all of the pages on our website. Now we can save the tag. We've added the Google Ads remarketing tag and the conversion linker tag to our Google Tag Manager container. Next, we're going to add the LinkedIn Insight tag to our website using Google Tag Manager. The LinkedIn Insight tag lets you report on the performance of your ads on LinkedIn and target ads to people who've been on your website. Okay, let's head to LinkedIn. I've already logged into LinkedIn and opened the Campaign Manager. We then need to select Analyze and select the Insight tag. Since we're going to add the tag using Google Tag Manager, let's select the option at the bottom that says I will use a tag manager. Now we need to copy our partner ID. And let's head to Google Tag Manager. We're still looking at our tags, so let's create a new tag. Let's name the tag LinkedIn Insight. Now let's select Tag Configuration. and let's search for LinkedIn and select the Insight tag. We just need to paste our partner ID as the tag ID. And now let's select Triggering. And let's choose the Initialization All Pages trigger. This will fire our tag on all of the pages of our website. And let's save the tag. Now that we've added the Google Ads Remarketing tag and the LinkedIn Insight tag, we're going to add the Metapixel for Facebook to our website using a custom HTML tag. Let's head to Facebook. I've already opened the Meta Business Suite and opened Events Manager. This is where we can get the Metapixel to add to our website. For this account, I've already created a pixel for my website, but if you're getting started for the first time and you don't have an existing pixel, you'll just need to select the option to set up the Metapixel. Since I already have a pixel, let's select Manage Integrations on the top right corner. Then for the Metapixel, let's select Manage and choose Install Pixel on New Website. Now let's choose the option to manually add the pixel code. And let's select Install Base Code on the left. We're now given the pixel code to add to our website, so let's copy this code. And let's head to Google Tag Manager. Now we need to create a new tag. Let's name the tag Metapixel Base Code. And let's select Tag Configuration. And let's choose custom HTML as the tag type. Now we can paste our base code. And let's select Advanced. And under Tag Firing Options, let's change once per event to once per page. This will mean that the Metapixel isn't fired multiple times as someone is browsing a page on our website. Now let's select Triggering. And we're going to select the Initialization All Pages trigger. Like the other tags we've already added, this will mean that our Metapixel for Facebook is added to all of the pages of our website. Now let's save our tag. We've now added the Metapixel for Facebook. So that's how we can add additional tags to Google Tag Manager. What tags are you going to implement using Google Tag Manager? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you'd like to learn more about Google Tag Manager, then subscribe to my channel because I will be releasing more tutorials. We'll be covering how to preview and test your tags, migration steps, and how to track conversions. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.